custom fields give decision makers the tools to create the reports they need without using extra classes, locations, or extra rows on the chart of accounts. Custom fields provides 12 additional customer fields, 12 additional sales fields, 12 additional purchase order and expense form fields, and 12 additional vendor fields. QuickBooks Online Advanced users receive an additional 48 fields in all. That's a lot of additional reporting flexibility. Here are some examples of how you can use custom fields to track info about your vendors and expenses. First, click the gear icon. Choose custom fields under the list column. Click Add Custom Field. Once your dialog box pops up in the right-hand side of the screen, add the name of your custom field. QuickBooks will give you name suggestions that you may want to use. I will choose Customer Type as my custom field name. Next, you choose the data type with options of text and number, number only, date, or drop-down list. I will choose the drop-down list as a data type. I will add residential and commercial as drop-down list options. I can add up to 100 drop-down items per drop-down list. Next, select your category. I have chosen the customer category. What this does is it will add it to the custom field tab in your customer section. Then select forms where you want the custom field to show. I have chosen to show on sales receipts, invoices, and estimates. This will show in the header section of your forms. Click on the slider to have the custom field print on the form. Select Save once finished. Now I will show you where the customer custom field shows. Let's create a new invoice. Click New Invoice. The customer type will show in the header of your invoice screen. Next, let's look at the customer screen. Go to Sales, Customers, then choose New Customer. Choose the tab for custom fields. This is where you can choose your customer type. The next example I'm going to show is to set up sales rep in the transaction category. Click the gear icon. Choose custom fields under the list column. Click Add Custom Field. Once your dialog box pops up in the right-hand side of the screen, add the name of your custom field. Again, QuickBooks gives name suggestions you may want to use. I will choose Sales Rep as my custom field name. Next, you choose a data type. I will choose the drop-down list as the data type. I will add Sean and Jared as the drop-down list options. Again, I can add up to 100 drop-down items per drop-down list. Next, select your category. I will choose the transaction category. What this does is adds it to the custom field tab in your forms. As a side note, I think that QuickBooks was trying to copy Enterprise's transaction feature, but Online Advanced doesn't allow the customer transaction field to show up in the detail section of the form. A huge miss from the developers, but hopefully they will get it fixed. Then select forms where you want the custom field to show. I have chosen to show on sales receipts, invoices, and estimates. This will show in the header section of your forms. Click on the slider to have the custom field print on the form. Select Save once finished. Now I will show you where your customer custom field shows. Let's create a new invoice. So we'll click New Invoice. Now I will show you where the Sales Rep field shows. Sales Rep field will show in the header of your invoice screen. The next example I'm going to show is to set up the Vendor ID Rep in the Vendor category. Click the gear icon, choose Custom Fields under the List column, click Add Field. Once your dialog box pops up in the right-hand side of the screen, add the name of your custom field. And one more time, QuickBooks gives name suggestions you may want to use. I will choose Vendor ID as my custom field name. Next, you choose the data type with options of text and number, number only, date, or drop-down list. I will choose the text and number as a data type. Next, select your category. I will choose the vendor category. What this does is add it to the custom field tab in your forms and in the vendor section. Then select forms where you want the custom field to show. I have chosen to show on purchase orders and bills. Click on the slider to have the custom field print on the form. Then select Save once finished. This will show in the header section of your forms and in the vendor section. The custom fields dashboard will first show the name and category of each custom field. The sales section checkmarks which forms the custom field will appear on, whether it's a sales receipt, invoice, estimate, credit memo, and refund receipt. The purchase section checkmarks which forms the custom field will appear on, whether it's a purchase order, expense, bill, check, vendor, credit, and credit card credit. If you choose to print on your form, you will see a printer icon. Under the last section with actions, click the drop-down to edit or make the custom field inactive. As a side note, I think that QuickBooks Online Advanced is missing an opportunity to add products and services to their custom field list. QuickBooks Enterprise has custom fields that are created from their items section. QuickBooks Online Advanced doesn't allow the product service category, so it doesn't show up in the details section of the form. I hope they will add it soon.
Thanks for watching my video on QuickBooks Online Advanced. For me to keep making more videos to show you how to get the most from QuickBooks, please subscribe and click on the bell to be notified when these new videos are made. Thanks again.